I used to see is the disparities in terms of performance in school for kids that are in the village and the kids that are in schools that have electricity. Teachers will give you homework and they expect you to have done it the next day morning. The teacher can't understand that you didn't have enough kerosene at home. If you look at a person who is earning less than $2 or less than $1 in a day, and that's money they have to get food, they have to buy kerosene. It's a big burden for these people. Kerosene lamps, because you have to read, so you put it on the table very close because it doesn't have enough light. It produces smoke which goes into my eyes. So I developed eye problems. I saw it happening, and I saw kids in the village, some of them dropping out of school.
Traditionally, school in Kenya runs between 8 a.m. in the morning to 5 p.m. in the evening. And this is the time when children in Samburu culture have to take care of the animals.
So in the evening, they come at around 6. Classes start when the darkness starts. You cannot have a shepherd class without lighting.
The real motivation that made me to come to try and see if I can come up with a solution. I design and make solar-powered lanterns called mangabora, which is a Swahili word which means good light. I designed and started making solar lamps in 2004, and up to now made local and distributed over 14,000 lamps.
My vision is that we will be able to provide a lamp per child.
Children actually use this lamp in class, and when they go home, they can use it also to carry on their homework.
The villages where we've taken the lamps to, we've noticed a big improvement now, because we'll find that enrollment now from elementary school to high school has gone up. Now, once they get the lamp, we're eliminating a part of that money they spend on kerosene.
Then they can be able to save that money and start some sustainable income generating projects.
Tuendelea, asa.
In a way, it's actually reducing the cycle of poverty.
Pesa hii, sisi anakisa chukua yeye, akebereka mahali ya kuku.
Naambia Evans asante na endelee kutusaidia sisi wamama wajane ambao tumebaki katika area ya Nyahobe.